All right, Mr. Telefero TV, how's everybody doing out there? Let me first send a congratulations to T.I. Clifford Harris on his 10th album, The Dime Trap, available right now. If y'all have not done so, please check that project out. I'm going to jam out to it tomorrow in the whip. Now, T.I. did something really special, and I feel like in interviews, he's kind of, I ain't saying he's dodging the question, but he ain't going to come out and say what I want him to say, because he is doing something really dope that I feel like we need to talk about in the culture. Now, I have not got the opportunity to get to T.I.'s Trap Museum in Atlanta, Georgia yet. I am going to do that soon. I don't know why the publishers group doing this event didn't reach out to me to cover this event. It's cool and no hard feelings. I'm going to cover this anyways, you know what I mean? Because I think it's super dope for the culture. And ironically, we're going to do a crap ton more views than a lot of outlets that are covering that event. No shade. Listen, man, T.I. has this Trap Museum in Atlanta again, kind of to not only commemorate his 10th studio album, but to kind of celebrate trap music. I know trap music has somewhat of a negative connotation behind it because, let's call it what it is, a lot of the artists that helped develop trap music came up through the drug culture. A lot of these artists, I mean, hell, words from T.I.'s mouth, they sold crap. You get where they're at right now. They use their struggles and selling drugs, being in the hood, feeling trapped, having to work, move work. They use that and they got themselves in a position to put money behind their music and become successful. A lot of artists, that's their story and certain different variations of it, but that's the core elements of it. And a lot of people don't believe trap music deserves to be celebrated. I'm not of that belief. Trap music got me through a lot of hard times in my life, though I'm not condoning drug usage or selling drugs to people or kids or whatever you want to call it. Let's just call it what it is, man. It was an avenue for a lot of broke black people to use their drug experiences in the past, talk about it, make money, and empower a lot of other people, all right? So it ain't just the trappers who turned rappers who benefited. It's the barber of the trapper who's now been able to create a barbershop and empower other people. It's the manager who's now been able to manage other acts. It's the agent who's been able to manage or represent the trapper turned rapper. And now he manages and represents as an agent for plenty other artists. Look, man, say what you want. Trap music has helped a lot of people out. It'll help to a degree. It affords me an opportunity to talk to you guys on a day-to-day basis. We cover a lot of trap artists or artists that came up through the trap era. So we look, man, you take it for what it's worth. Now, with T.I. doing this dope trap museum, it's one thing that was up in the air. Will you celebrate every artist, even rappers you don't have a great relationship? We covered the Who Created Trap Music a couple months ago. T.I., Gucci, they were going back and forth through different Instagram accounts, all both saying that, look, I created trap music. You know, I'm the soul, you know, the creator of trap music. In Gucci's case, he believes he was actually rapping about the trap first. And T.I.'s like, I actually coined the term trap music. And in T.I.'s defense, he's like, yo, if you want to say you were the first trap rapper, we could take it back before Gucci to artists like UGK and company who, you know, maybe they didn't use the word trap, but they were talking about things that were going on in the trap. So again, it's an ongoing debate. Who knows who created trap music? From what I've told, most artists that I asked, they tell me Gucci was one of the first artists they heard trap music being discussed, but T.I. was the one who coined that term trap as a project title. So again, who knows, who cares? But one question that was up in the air when T.I. created this trap music is, will you celebrate Gucci Mane in it? And again, T.I., being a modest person, not trying to create any conflict and really not wanting to speak on Gucci's name like that, because I don't think T.I. and Gucci hate each other, obviously not like a Gucci and Jeezy, but they don't rock with each other. It ain't no love lost with each other, right? I don't think they just hate each other in 2018. They just don't, right? And the fact that T.I., you know, he's going around in an interview saying, we're celebrating every artist, no matter who they is. They got contributions to trap music. We celebrate them. The fact that T.I. gave Gucci his spot in this trap museum, I've seen images and people I know that have been to the museum told me about it. I think it's super dope. I think it's the mature route to go. That's dope, man. He gave Gucci, like, Gucci's got like the refrigerator, if I'm not mistaken, the Brewer refrigerator and all that, and some different little memorabilia from Gucci and his, what he contributed to trap music, and you know, some of the projects that he has. It's all in that trap museum. And you know, that's dope, man. And T.I. deserves a pat on the back, whatever you want to do, because he could have took the petty rap and just omitted Gucci and his contributions and still been able to talk about artists like himself, a Jeezy, a few other artists that have really, really took trap music to another level. But he didn't do that. He included Gucci Man in this mix. And I think that's him being a bigger person. And I think it's super dope. And I don't think enough people are talking about it. I wish I could be telling you guys this from the scene of the Trap Museum, but they ain't bring your boy out. Hopefully they fix it when they see this video, do a crap ton of views in the future, and have your boy in attendance for openings like the Trap Museum in Atlanta, Georgia. But again, salute to T.I. Y'all go check out that Dime Trap, T.I.'s 10th studio album. And if you're in the Atlanta or in the Georgia area, go to T.I.'s Trap Museum. That thing is not going to be around forever. T.I., as a matter of fact, words out of his mouth, he said he's going to keep it up as long as he can make money off of it and not come out of pocket. I don't think he's trying to make money, but as long as he's not having to spend a crap ton of money to keep it open, I'm going to check it out soon. I think you should do the same. If you've benefited off trap music, and I'm not just talking about financially benefited off trap music, but if trap music can help you get through some hard times, when you thought about doing some crazy stuff, you should probably support this museum, because it's the first time we've seen somebody celebrate this spot. Like, trap music is now 10, 15, 20 years in the canon now. And it's changed Atlanta culture for sure. And if Atlanta runs hip hop and trap music runs Atlanta, obviously we're saying trap music is probably the most popping genre of rap music. Thank y'all so much for the time, love, and support. I do not take it for granted. Salute. I'm out. I came from nothing, but I want everything God has for me. I interview celebrities. I talk sports. I still represent the culture.
I got the kids. They tuned in.
Are now tuned in.
Tuned in.
Yo, we locked in right now,
Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Shout out to Mr. Telefair.
You watching Mr. Telefair TV.
Mr. Telefair TV. Here with the Triple B's, you can't do nothing but win.